That was a short composition in Raag Kedar.
Good evening and welcome everybody to Bloom Bars. And thank you for coming on such a night. There's actually plenty of seats available up front if you want to move up front. And as John was saying earlier, this is something that you enjoy up close. And there is an interaction that happens between the performers, namely us on stage and you. And if we see that you're enjoying the music, that inspires us to perform. So as I was saying, welcome and thank you for coming. hopefully the weather will behave and we will warm up the arena here with our music. It's our humble way of welcoming everybody. Now, Sid talked about playing a raga, and a raga is, as some of you are well familiar with our music, Indian classical music, which has these melodic structures which are similar to scales in Western music, but not quite. These are, a raga is made up of a specific structure of notes going up and down up the scale and down the scale in a specific way. But the more important thing about a raga is actually the mood that it evokes. So you heard one of these ragas, and these are based on the time of the day as well as seasonal. So there are certain ragas that appeal to the human mind at certain seasons or definitely at certain times of the day. So because it's evening and basically people are done with their day, the work, they're relaxing, so the mood tends to be more less energetic and more soothing and more mellow. And so the rags actually reflect that in their melodic structure. So I am going to play, and by the way, this I'm not sure if some of you or most of you have seen this instrument before. I'm not going to go into a lecture demonstration about the instrument itself. It's called the sarod, and here Debu was playing the tabla, the two-headed Indian drums. And the sarod is, the uniqueness of the sarod is actually that it's fretless, and it otherwise looks very much similar to a guitar or a lute, or if you've seen the Greek oud, it looks similar. And like the Greek oud, this is also fretless, and the sharpness of the sound is actually brought about by the artist playing or using his or her fingernails on the finger plate, and it allows sliding movement, which is so unique to Indian music, and it represents vocal techniques, almost like the instrument is singing. So what we're going to do is present the first piece that I'm going to play is an evening raga, which I'm sure most of you have heard many times. And it's a popular raga, Raman Yamani Kalyan. And I'll play the way Indian classical music is presented is there is always a first section that is played without any kind of rhythmic structure. It's played freeform. And the idea is that section is called the alap. The alap, which is a Hindi word, when translated means introduction. So it introduces the melody to the audience, and you get a sense of what's coming in terms of a composition or whatever intricacies that the artist is going to show. And sometimes the alap can be pretty elongated and elaborate depending on the nature of the raga and also what the artist wants to present. So I'm going to play a shorter alap because this is the first piece, and I wanted to kind of give you a taste of what this raga sounds like, and then I'm going to play a traditional composition from my school, my gharana, as some of you may be familiar with this term, which emanated from a tiny, tiny village in northern India called Shahjahanpur, named after the Emperor Shahjahan. And Shahjahanpur still exists on the map. You can actually go to Google Maps and see this tiny village called Shahjahanpur. That's where some of the founding fathers of our musical tradition came from. And so the gharana was named after Shahjahanpur. And this composition was composed many, many, many years ago. And was by one of these maestros in our gharana. And I would say it dates back to almost, if not 200 years, it's probably only 150 years ago. And it's a beautiful composition, and it's set to 16 beats or teen thal. Teen thal means three claps. And maybe I'll give the microphone to Debu to explain why is it called teen thal.
take this one. The reason why it's called Teen Taal, because in India, in Hindi, taal, or the rhythmic cycle, is counted by keeping claps. In this particular cycle, there are three claps and one. So it goes basically like
note, and then you build on that. So that's why it's very important, his tonic on the tabla and my tonic are tuned to the same. Now, occasionally, because these are wooden instruments and because of the changes in temperature, you'll hear us retuning even in the middle of the program. It is actually fairly normal to do that, but in order to make sure that we're always playing in key, we'll have to retune and also during the course of the concert, because it starts to change in pitch. So without further ado, we'll start with Rag Yaman Kalyan.
Thank you. Thank you.
that was Rag Yaman Kalyan. And now as the night progresses, we're going to move to a Yaman Kalyan is played normally a little bit earlier in the evening than what we started at. But I wanted to give you a taste of what an early evening rag sounded like. And now I will move on to another rag that is played more aptly about around this time of the night. And it's called Rag Bageshri. And you'll hear the more mellower tones that are in this rag. And I'm going to do a little bit longer in terms of the alap that I played than I played in Yaman Kalyan. And I want to give you a taste of what it is like to play a more elaborate. And I don't know if you felt that in the Yaman Kalyan, these are quite spiritual in minded. So some of you who are used to doing yoga may be listening to this kind of music and meditating. It helps that kind of meditation. And this is our form of meditation as we are playing here on stage to understand the music. It's almost like worshiping the melody. So I'll play a little longer alap, and it goes into a section called the jor, which basically has a rhythm without a rhythmic cycle. And you'll hear that. And it's kind of, the rhythm is maintained by the instrumentalist, and it's not set to any particular beat cycle like we did in Teentab. And then I'm going to play two compositions, one set to a 7-beat cycle called Rupak, and then in Tintal, and finishing in a faster composition. So, Rag Bageshri.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
it's getting late. We will end with a short piece in Rag Mishra Kamaj. This is actually based on a song, a vocal composition, and this is a tradition which is sung in around the time of the color festival or Holi, and it's called a Chaiti. And this is for those of you who follow it, Chaitara Chundari Rangade is the lyrics, and it was sung by the most famous singer, Pandita and Shobha Gurtu. So we'll end with that, and it's set to Rag Tal Deep Chandi. Thank you.
Can we give Soumya Chakraverty another round of applause, please? As well as Devu Nayak, please. And of course, we can't forget Sid Lahari, who opened up for us in the back. Thank you, Sid. Thank you all so much for coming out to support these musicians. I know I can only speak for myself, but I feel like my whole aura, spirit has been cleansed, and it was beautiful. So thank you. Thank you so much. I think, David, you want to announce the 23rd? You guys appreciate these guys. These guys play like at sold-out, huge concert venues, auditoriums, and to see them here in this intimate setting is pretty beautiful. So thank you. Feel free to stick around, meet somebody new, chat these guys up, ask them questions. Thank you again for your donations. We really, really, really appreciate it. It means a lot. It keeps these doors open. And also supports this music. So thank you. Of course, we're sliding scale, so if you want to give more at the door, that's great. Those of you who gave us a smile at the donation box, we thank you. We love smiles. Always take a smile. But if you want to drop anything in the box, it really helps a lot. So thank you very much. Have a wonderful, wonderful weekend. Be safe in the snow, and we'll see you soon.
We just finished in time because the snow is just beginning to come down.
It's just starting to come down. All right. All right. Keep blooming, guys. Thank you.
I have